and your Salem International Fighting Tigers. Outside, it is a bone-chilling night, but inside, in this warm, friendly confine of the home arena for Salem International, we have a great event for you. Cedarville is 5-5 on the road, and Salem is 6-2 at home. After the last game, Salem showed dismal display in offense and defense in the second half, and just got trounced by Urbana Blue Knights. Salem has to come out this game and show some effort and drive and want to win, not just one half, but in both halves. They are still ranked second in the nation at this time with 13.2 steals a game. Something. They're still ranked second in the nation, ladies and gentlemen. And they have to continue that pressure on defense in order to stay in this game. They also have to start taking smarter shot selections on offense, not try and move the ball around so much, looking for that one easy shot. Try and take some more shots, put them up, grab those rebounds, and go back up for second chance points. Also, those unnecessary, unforced shots are going to cause a problem for Salem on defense tonight with this very tall, strong-sized Cedarville team. Cedarville is coming off a very, very tough loss on the road against Notre Dame College, who had beaten Salem in Notre Dame by a margin that should never have happened. Salem needs to be able to stay pressure on offense, pressure the deep ball on defense, and not give up when they come out for the second half. It's a cold night outside, like I said before, but we're inside, we're warm. We'll be back right after these messages. And we're back here at the T. Edwards Davis Gymnasium on the campus of Salem International University. Once again, where Cedarville Yellow Jackets are taking on the Salem International University Tigers. One note we have from the coaching staff is Kamar LeBrew is back after being out with a lower body injury for some time. Also, they are starting this game off with a very tall lineup, which we haven't seen them do, hoping for some change on the defensive side of the ball, and also have some presence on the inside paint, which has cost them a few rebounds here and there. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to stop talking and bring in my colleague, Chance Sharp. Chance, how are you today?
I'm doing good. A little chilly, but I get used to it.
Nothing more than good cold air up here in West Virginia, but I bet it's warm down in Arizona.
Oh, it always is.
Well, on that note, we're going to go and turn to Chance Sharp for his Sharp's key to the game.
My keys to the game tonight for Salem Tigers. They got to play with a chip on their shoulder. They had a rough outing against Urbana. They really got to come out today and show that, you know, they are a quality basketball team that they have shown all year long. And they got to play a full 40 minutes and hopefully come out and beat Cedarville here tonight. My second key to the game is also to be smart and be aggressive. Be aggressive on the boards. You know, win that rebound battle early. They got to be smart with their shot selection. Don't just run down the court and chuck up the first shot they get. You know, find a good quality shot and hopefully it goes in tonight. They got to get on a roll early. The last key, get back on track at home. They were 6-1 coming into that game against Urbana, and they really just shut down mentally, and it cost them the game late. Hopefully they come out tonight and prove that this is their home court and that they love playing here.
Well, Chance, thank you very much for those insights on the game. We're going to go over the starting lineup tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Here they are. First, starting with the visitors from Cedarville. He's a 6'8" center from Kingston, Jamaica. He's a junior, Brian Grant. Number 21, a guard standing 6 foot tall from Castle Rock, Colorado, Austin Foote. Number 24, a guard standing at 6'3", a senior from Mason, Ohio, Zach Brown. Number 32, a 6'7" senior from Lithonia, Georgia, Zimi Nwabo. And starting also at guard, wearing number 34, standing at 6'4", a sophomore from Poco, West Virginia, Jason Cuffey. And the starting lineup for the Salem International Fighting Tigers. Starting at guard, wearing number 3, standing 6'2", he's a sophomore from Washington, D.C., Jamal Robinson. Starting also at guard from Detroit, Michigan, standing 5'9", is a senior, wearing number 5, Raymar Porter. Wearing number 21, standing at 6'9", playing center, a junior from Brooklyn, New York, Walter Brock. A guard forward standing at 6'4", he's a junior from Murfreesboro, Tennessee, wearing number 23, Jonathan Roper. And standing 6'6", another forward, a senior from Clinton, Maryland, number 25, Dexter Batts Jr. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back with the tip-off from T. Edwards Davis Gymnasium. Yeah, I told you, skinny legs. Starting at 4, Ladies and gentlemen, game's about to start. We got a tip off. Going for the tip for Sam International, number 21, Walter Brock. And jumping for Cedarville, number 13, Brian Grant. And here we go. Tip goes to Salem.
Big Walter Brock with that tip off there to Dexter Batts. Here come the Tigers.
I've noticed Dexter Batts is sporting some eyewear after getting poked in the eye, but I believe 2 games ago what it was.
Also sporting a mouthpiece here tonight.
And a headband, looks good.
New wardrobe for Dexter Batts.
New wardrobe, new offense, maybe a start they need. Brock into lane, pass to Roper, rejected, rebound goes to Brock, and tipped out of bounds by Cedarville.
Nice job there by Roper and Walter Brock there just to continue going after the ball rather than just, you know, being content with missing that shot and giving Cedarville the ball.
3 seconds left on the shot clock. Salem's got to get it off quickly. Oh, shot clock violation by Salem. Didn't pay attention to those 3 seconds.
Mental lapse there. Hopefully they build off of that and have better possessions from here on out.
Bringing the ball up for Cedarville, number 24, Zach Brown. Salem sitting in a 3-2 zone. Done some good job for them on defense in past games. Brown for three. Rim out, rebound. Walter Brock.
That's what Walter Brock brings. Good rebounder. Hopefully he does that the entire night.
Brock from the baseline is good.
Not only can he rebound, but he can shoot.
Big man, good jump shot, good size in the middle. Something Salem's needed for a few games. Oh, fouls on number 23, Jonathan Roper. His first, team's first.
Got to be a little quicker on defense to not leave that man on the other side of the court open. Right underneath.
Layup's no good. Rebound, Walter Brock.
Biggest man on the court. That's what he should do.
Ooh, that is just being run over by a truck. Fouls on number 13, Brian Grant. His first, team's third. First. Raymar Porter inbound the ball. Tipped out of bounds by Cedarville.
Good look there by Walter Brock. Good defense there by Cedarville.
Once again, number 5, Raymar Porter, inbound the ball. That's up top to Robinson, to Porter, trying to set up the offense, find a shot, and get some more points on the board. Good ball movement so far by Salem on the offensive side. Porter, jump back jumper, no good. Rebound goes to number 24, Brown.
Good patient offense there. Looked like a good look there by Raymar Porter, just didn't go in.
Cuffey takes a shot for three and is fouled from behind the arc. By number 21, Walter Brock, his first, team second. As I recall, I think they had about 4 fouls like that against Urbana that could really cost them the game that second half.
Yeah, they really got to play smart when it comes to the fouls and defense in general.
First two shots are good. Third shot is up and is good. Bring the ball up half court is number 5, Raymar Porter. Cedarville playing a full court press. And an over and back ball called on Salem. I believe Dexter Batts has stepped on the line.
Good full court press there by Cedarville. Good pressure defense early. Salem really didn't know what to do with it.
Brown bringing the ball past half court. Salem's got to push the ball a little bit more. Shooter continuously looks for that man behind the arc or number 32 inside. Coffee for three. Rebound.
Nice defense there by the Tigers. Good pressure defense. Got a hand in the shooter's face. Caused him to miss that shot.
Exactly. Couldn't have better said it myself. Porter from the corner. Rim out. No. Rebound. Robinson. Putback is good.
Nice job by Jamal Robinson. Good hustle. Off the missed shot there by Porter. Got a nice easy layup. Nice job there by Jamal Robinson.
Good job there following a shot, getting the rebound. Jumper from Grant is good. Block on the baseline. Inside to Dexter Batts, who finds Roper. Trying to set up a little triangle offense there. Didn't work out that well.
Salem's got to look to get a nice high percentage shot. They can't just sit back and wait for it to come to them. Cedarville's also playing some pretty good defense here.
Very, very tight defense so far. Causing Salem to use up almost the whole shot clock every time. Bats into the lane. Kicks it out to Porter. Porter from behind the arc. Rimmed out. No good.
Porter not afraid to shoot that three ball here tonight. He's already missed 3 of them. He'll get in the groove, hopefully.
Brown into the lane. Kick out for 3. Rim, rebound, Walter Brock.
Walter Brock, biggest man on the court, another rebound, and here come the Tigers, hopefully to score some points on this possession.
Be a good transition here, get the rebound, get down the court, go up by 1, hopefully 2. Batts looked inside, could not find it, kicked it back out. Robinson trying to set up a play on offense. Cedarville doing a very good job defending all the plays Salem has thrown at them.
Offense looking a little stiff right now.
And a turnover by Salem.
Too many passes there. Didn't even look for a shot opportunity there. That's why they caused a turnover.
Marble in the lane and is fouled. Fouls on number 21. Hit second, team's third. Thank you. entering the game for Sale, number 32, Jeremy Sewell, as well, number 0, Kamar LeBrew.
Welcome back, KK LeBrew, after the injury. Good to see him back out on the court.
Entering the game for Cedarville, number 1, Brian Hecker, number 22, Marcus Renke. Second shot, no good. Rebound. Push off the back. Fouls on number 1, White. His first, team second. And then again, for Cedarville, number 5, Leighton Smith.
Hopefully, Kamar LeBrew can come in and run this offense and set up some good shots here. You know, they really couldn't do that the first couple minutes of this game with Raymar Porter running that offense.
Hopefully, it brings back the energy they needed. And they've been missing for the past few games with him being on the sideline watching as a spectator. Kamar, pump fake, shot from behind the arc. No good, rebound, goes back to Kamar. Inside, to Robinson, pump fake layup is good.
Nice job, Kamar LeBrew, finding Jamal Robinson there, wide open underneath the basket. Jamal's got two nice easy layups here early on.
Score is tied 6-6 with 14:30 to go in the first half. Cedarville continuously looking for that one easy pass inside. Shot from behind the arc is no good. And out of bounds, Salem ball.
It's tough to have Walter Brock already on the bench. You know, he's got 4 rebounds already in this game, but already has 2 fouls. He's got a limit. Limit the fouls here tonight to keep him in the ball game and continue getting rebounds.
Back. Kamar LeBrew running the offense again. Trying to find the offensive player he needs to help him light up the lamp. And Batts from behind the arc. Rebound goes to Cedarville.
Good look there by Dexter Batts. Just not going in right now. They got to start making these shots. Already 3 of 8 early on.
Taking some good open shots. Just not being able to make them fall does hurt early on.
They are playing well on the defensive end. Cedarville's 1 of 6. From the field right now, the only thing, 4 of 5 from the free throw line. That's the difference in this game. The fouls already in the first 6 minutes of this game.
Well, we got another foul on the floor. Fouls on number 23, Jonathan Roper. His second, team's 4th.
That is a problem for this team right now, committing way too many silly fouls to put their backs up against the wall from right in the beginning of the game.
Entering the game for Sale, number 4, Kenneth Cornell, and number 1, Freddie Edouard. Hopefully Freddie and Kenny can help out on the offensive end and get baskets to fall, turn the scoreboard around, put them in the lead.
What about the black uniforms tonight, Miles? Look good.
They do. It's something I like to see at home, probably, hopefully more often.
Good pressure there by the energy man, Freddie Edouard. Miss that layup right there.
Henry Cornell drive into the lane, finger roll, no good. Rebound to Cedarville. Why would he stop there when he had an open lane to drive through?
He just didn't want to take the easy layup. He wanted the three ball, that's why. They're going to call over the back there on Cedarville.
Good job there by Kamar LeBrew for boxing out, getting the foul call.
The Salem offense, 3 of 10 from the field right now, 0 of 4 from three-point land. They just cannot get discouraged. They're getting good looks right now. They're just not making them. They got to stay tough mentally, and eventually those shots will go in.
Until the game for Cedarville, number 13, Brian Grant. Number 32, Zimmy Nwabo. And number 22, Marquis Renke. Freddy Adwar from behind the arc is good.
Wide open three for Freddy Adwar right there. Good look by Jonathan Roper for the assist.
Something they need more often. Easy passes, open shots, make those baskets count from here on out.
That's what Kamar LeBrew brings to this club, driving that ball in, spread the defense out, and laid a wide open shot.
Another steal for the second ranked team of the nation, and a layup by Freddy Adwar.
Nice job there, Freddy Adwar. Nice job there by Kamar LeBrew to find him down the court for the easy layup.
Bringing in Kenneth McCoy now, and Freddy Adwar seem to has changed the tempo of this game. Inside to Zimmy Nwabo. First shot no good. Second shot fall in good.
You're exactly right though, Miles. Kamar LeBrew has brought a good solid energy to this team. You know, for the just a few minutes that he's been in, this offense has really changed.
Rear to the game, first down, number 5, Raymar Porter.
Yeah, that, as he's leading this offense.
Yeah.
Take him right out.
Well, he did just get smothered by a big guy. He kind of does bring for some caution and want to make sure he's not hurt himself again after coming off a lower body injury.
Absolutely. You don't want to rush it too quick and cause further injury.
Raymar Porter cutting through the lane. Layup is no good, but he'll go to the line for 2.
One thing Raymar Porter can do from coming off the bench with this energy, all he's got to do is continue it. Plenty of guys out there like Freddy Adwar, Kenneth McCornell, guys with good energy, good shooters. Raymar Porter's just got to continue that.
The foul was on number 14, his first, team's 4th. Raymar Porter line shoot, first foul shot is good. We're into the game, 4th sale, number 21, Walter Brock. To the line, take a second shot. Back rim, rebound, Cedarville. And it's foul right off the rebound by number 1, Freddy Adwar. His first, team's 5th. Salem looks to be running a modified full court press. And looks like they're going into a man-to-man defense this time.
Good idea here by the Salem defense. Stay in front of the Cedarville offense. Just can't push.
Foul's on number 1, Freddy Adwar. His second, team's 6th. Another game for Salem, number 3, Jamal Robinson. Never knew you could push like that in basketball.
Not allowed to. I don't know why they do it. Good defense there, and they're going to get charged with a foul. Good defense there by Jeremy Sewell and Raymar Porter.
Foul is on number 32, Jeremy Sewell. His first, team 7, and Cedarville is already in the bonus with 11:30 to go in the first half.
One thing that should not happen right there. Too many sloppy fouls here early on. And that's what really has Cedarville in this game right now.
Salem currently leads 12-8 with 11:29 to go. Second shot is up, and it's good. And the game for Cedarville, number 34, Jason Cuffey.
Kind of the same start we saw against Urbana. Real slow on the offensive end. Getting by, doing good on the board so far. Gotta play better on offense, and hopefully these shots are going down.
Sewell into lane, pump fake floater, no, it's good, rolls in.
Exactly what we're looking for there by Sewell. Nice shot there, and it went in, extending the lead for the Tigers. Good defense there by Porter.
Good switch off on the man there by Sewell. Slammed home by number 32, Xavier Nwabo.
Nice job there by Raymar Porter. It's going the other way.
Fouls on number 5, Raymar Porter. His first, team's 8th. End of the game for Salem, Kmar LeBrew.
Cedarville, 5 points already from the free throw line. That's a big difference in this game right now.
As well, entering the game for Salem, number 25, Dexter Batts Jr. First shot is good. As a reward, he gets a second shot for making his first. Second shot is good by number 14, Daniel Hickman. Entering the game for Cedarville, number 24, Zach Brown.
Here comes Cedarville with the press here. KK LeBrew, sloppy turnover there, back to Cedarville.
Cedarville slowing the ball down, even though they had possession very early and deep in that offensive zone. Drive into the lane is good. Count it and the foul.
Oh, he drove it hard to the basket, drew some contact, made the layup, and drew the foul. Back to the line he goes.
Foul's on number 4, Kenneth Cornell. His first, team's 9. To the line, number 34.
Another foul.
Jason Cuffey.
These free throws have changed the game. They've now given Cedarville the lead with all these free throws.
This is their 10th free throw with still over half of a half to go.
Half the half to go here in this one.
Cedarville in that full court press that caused Salem some trouble last time.
Gotta get it over.
And they do. Walter Brock into the lane and a blocking foul called on Cedarville.
Nice shot there for the Salem Tigers, driving in, drawing some contact. Hopefully these balls start to go in the basket.
Fouls on number 14, his second, team set to the line to shoot two, number 21, Walter Brock. Back rebound and out. Second one is up and rims in. Cedarville slowly finding a way to set up their offense every time down the court, not rushing the shots. I'm trying to look for that big guy inside. Shot from behind the arc is good, and the foul.
Gotta be smarter there on the defensive end. Twice tonight that has happened. One of the guys shooting a three-pointer and he gets fouled. This time he made it. A chance for a four-point play right now for Cedarville.
Fouls on number 4, Kenneth Cornell. His second, team's 10th. Cedarville is now in the double bonus.
Undisciplined defense going on right now here by the Tigers. Committing silly foul after silly foul. If they want to stay in this game, that's going to have to change.
Thank you. At the line, number 34, Jason Cuffey, shooting his potential four-point play. And it's good. That's 4 points unnecessarily given away by Salem. Cedro still sits in that full court press. Salem slowly finding a way to penetrate. And they do. Kamala Boo drives into the lane. Floater is no good. Rebound. Brock!
Nice job down off the Brock with the putback slam.
Salem setting up in a full court press off defense. And easily penetrated by Cedarville.
Cedarville, you know, they move the ball real well. They're big and strong. You know, Salem's got to toughen up defensively.
Walter Brock to Robinson. Robinson pump fake back out to Kamar LeBrew. Shot is good from Kamar LeBrew.
Kamar LeBrew looks to come up a little limp right there. Call into the bench and they're going to have to take him out.
In the game for Kamar LeBrew, number one, Freddie Dwar.
Looks like it's that same ankle injury that's been hobbling him for the past few weeks. Tough luck there for the Tigers.
Cedarville still trying to find that man open, driving to the lane. Layup is good. What a shot.
Circus shot there right off the top of the backboard. Nice job by that Cedarville guard.
Raymar Porter from behind the arc is good.
I told you you'd make one eventually. There you go, Raymar Porter for three.
Hopefully one of many tonight. Got to get him to get hot, keep him on the court. Brown from behind the arc is good for three. Cedarville leads 25-22 with 8.5 to go. Porter continuously looks for that three-pointer shot. Bats pump fake, drives into the lane. Floater off backboard. Rebound to Cedarville.
Nice job by Dexter Bats, driving it to the hole. Didn't get it to go in, though.
Good defense there by Freddie. From behind the arc is number 21. Rebound goes to Walter Brock.
Good defense by the Tigers. You know, keeping a hand in their face. Really didn't get them an open shot there for Cedarville. That's the type of defense the Tigers need to play. They weren't slapping their hands. They weren't chipping around. They didn't hit anybody. You know, they just put a body in front of them, and it caused a low percentage shot and a defensive rebound.
Reason of the game for Salem, number 32, Jeremy Seville, and number 0, Kamar LeBrew. Porter's double teamed in the corner, spins out of it, pass to Seville, layup in the lane, no good, rebound to Raymar Porter. Kamar LeBrew from behind the arc is fouled.
He was definitely hit as he shot there. He's going to the line. For two. For three, I apologize. I was wrong. He was behind the line.
He was. Fouls on number 21, Austin Foote, his first, team seventh. Salem is now in the single bonus. First shot is no good. Big difference I see on the stat sheet is Cedarville's been to the line 11 times compared to Salem's 5 after the shot.
And that contributes to the Salem defense. You know, early on they were, you know, smacking guys and really, really committing, you know, sloppy fouls. And they, you know, that's the difference in the game. That's why Cedarville's in the lead. They have 9 points just off free throws alone.
Free giveaway points Salem does not have to give to other teams.
They are free throws.
That is very true. That is why they are called that. 2-3 from the line. Salem trails by one with 7.5 to go.
Breaking the press nice and easy there is Cedarville. Hopefully the Salem Tigers defense can stop them.
That was
good defense there by the Tigers. thought he's all over the place. Cedarville offense didn't know what to do with the ball there, so he walked with it. You're not allowed to do that.
No, you're not.
Here comes Kmar LeBrew.
Kmar calling out an offensive play, trying to find. It's like Raymar Porter in the corner. Sam keeps trying to find a play that works here. Cedarville seems to be sitting back in a 2-3 zone so far. Shot from behind the arc is good for Raymar Porter.
Nice job there by Raymar Porter, making another one.
Long pass for the inbound to Brown.
Salem's really got to keep this intensity up.
Wombo inside, fouled by Freddie Edouard. Basket is good. To line, shoot one. We're into the game for Cedarville. Number 2-2, Marcus Renke. Number 44, Caleb Maxwell. And for Salem, number 25, Dexter Batts Jr.
Salem's got to keep the intensity up here. That was a good hard foul there by Freddie Edouard, but keep the intensity up.
Freddie Edouard currently has 3 fouls, and it's not even 6 minutes left in the first half.
Freddie Edouard's got 3. Jonathan Roper and Walter Bruck each have 2. Kenny McConnell also has 2. That's a lot of fouls.
Jeremy Sewell looking for a lane. Couldn't find it. Closed off very well. Very nicely there by Cedarville. Raymar Porter from behind the arc once again. It's good.
Somebody's starting to get hot.
Keep going.
Go outside and warm up a little bit.
We're not in Arizona so far. It's only about 7 degrees outside. It is bone chilling out there. Fouls on number 25, Dexter Batts Jr., his first.
Give some credit there for Raymar Porter. He started out 0 for 3. Now he's made his last 3. Way to stay with it and keep this team in it.
Salem leads 30-28 with 5:56 to go in the first half. First shot is good. Caleb Max out of line to shoot second. Rebound, it's good. Kmar LeBrew bringing the ball up. Cedarville not playing a press on defense. Long Salem go down low and set up on their offense. Kmar crosses up and loses the ball.
Lost the handle, trying to drive it over to the corner there, and Cedarville got a hold of it, and Salem committed a foul.
To the line.
That's a foul.
To the line to shoot two. Number 22, Marcus Renke. First shot is good. Entering the game for Salem, number 4, Kenneth Cornell. And number 23, Jonathan Roper. Second shot is good. Salem trails 32-30 with 5:40 to go in the first half.
Gotta have a good possession here and definitely get some points.
Offensive foul on Salem.
Committing fouls on the offense and defensive end now. Back to the line. No, they're not back to the line yet. Sorry.
Bring the ball up for Cedarville. Number 14, Daniel Hickman. Wobble from the foul line. No good. Rebound. Cedarville from behind the arc. No good. Rebound. Sewell.
Nice job there by the Tigers. Another rebound. They're actually winning the rebound margin right now. 14-9 early on here in this game.
Salem looking for that shot from behind the arc right now. Cedarville's playing some really tough inside defense, and a turnover caused by Cedarville's defense.
Except right in the line of that pass, got an easy steal.
Two rebounds to Cedarville, a third one to Cedarville, and a foul.
Four Salem Tigers around that Cedarville offensive player, Caleb Maxwell. You know, when you have four guys around, somebody's got to grab that rebound.
Briefly game for Salem, number 21, Walter Brock.
Caleb Maxwell to the line for the 17th time today for Cedarville.
Back in the game for Salem, number 0, Kamar LeBrew. Second shot, rebound, goes to Sewell. Cedarville in a full court press.
Nice job by Kamar LeBrew to get around there.
Salem looking to set up an offense. Seems that Cedarville sitting in his zone. That's inside to Sewell, into the lane, passes to Brock, and a turnover once again for Salem.
One too many passes there. Sewell might have had a shot there. Chose to pass instead, and another turnover.
Another foul on number 21, Walter Brock. I believe that's his third of the half.
Three first half fouls just for one guy alone. Tough to play like that. It's tough to play with your backs up against the wall, as Salem's done here in the first half.
First shot is good. End of the game for Salem, number 23, Jonathan Roper. At the line for Cedarville, number 32, Zimi Nwabo. Second shot is up. And it's good. Cedarville seems that like that full court press against Salem.
Almost had another turnover there, but the they're going to call a foul here on Cedarville.
Foul is on number 34, Jason Cuffey. His second, team's 8. Salem is in the bonus, the 1-1. And ladies and gentlemen, for you guys, people listening out there, if you don't know, if he makes his first free throw, he's rewarded with the second one. If he misses his first one, play continues. First shot is good, and that means he's rewarded with the second shot.
You are correct, Miles.
Second shot is front rim. Rebound goes to Cedarville. Salem in a full court press, causing some trouble for Cedarville.
Nice job there by the Tigers Timeout Cedarville. Good defense there by Jamal Robinson. A full court press there by the Tigers. Great job right there causing Cedarville to get all whacked out there on the offensive end.
Whacked out, flustered, confused, not knowing what to do.
So many verbs for it.
Oh, it's amazing.
Adjectives, nouns, you can pretty much say anything right there.
That you can, Chance. I'd like to throw one other stat out there, ladies and gentlemen, is that Cedarville has been to the line 20 times this half and has made 17 of those free throws. They've only taken 21 shots from the floor and have only made 8 of them. The huge difference in this game, which is allowing Cedarville to lead with 4 minutes to go in the half, 35-31, is those 20 free throws.
Salem's, they've put themselves in this situation. Sloppy fouls early on in the game have led, to the little chippy fouls you hear now, the good hard fouls. You know, it's leading to the line. I mean, the sloppy fouls early on have really put them in a bad spot here in this first half.
Shot is good by number 22, Marcus Reinke. Kmar LeBrew back in the game, calling out an offense, trying to get this team in sync, and a turnover by Kenneth Cornell. Hickman layup rejected by number 4, Kenneth Cornell. That is a hustle play there. Turns the ball over, gets back on defense, causes the ball not to go in their basket, and Salem is rewarded with the foul.
You just wish, the turnovers wouldn't happen. Again, they've put themselves in this situation. 9 turnovers in this first half. But way to hustle back there. Give him credit for hustling back, getting the block, and Jamal Robinson drawing the foul. Now he's going to the line himself.
First shot is good. The foul was on number 44, Caleb Maxwell. His first team's 9th. And back in the game for Salem, number 5, Raymar Porter. Second shot is up and no good. Rebound, Nwabo.
In and out there. Tough luck there for Jamal Robinson.
Salem playing a man-to-man pressure defense to end this first half. Florida in the lane is good. Inside Jonathan Roper, one-on-one with Caleb Maxwell, underneath the hoop, fake, pump fake, no good, rebound, goes to Caleb Maxwell.
Not the best shot selection there by Roper. Could have passed it out and started the offense over there.
Cedarville continuously looks inside for number 32, who is their leading scorer for the year and has caused some trouble for Salem today. Inside.
Big, strong guy, and the Tigers are having a hard time adjusting to that here in this game, in this first half.
Back in the game for Salem, number 0, Kmar LeBlue, and number 5, Leighton Smith. Foul is on number 44, Caleb Maxwell, team's 10th, his 2nd.
Coach Unger is going to trim the height down on this Salem team. A lot of short guys out there. Hopefully build some speed and good shooters out there.
Kmar LeBrew showing his speed off underneath the basket. Active hands by Cedarville, pushes the ball out of bounds. Salem ball to inbound the ball. You did mention they trimmed down the height, but that should have nothing to do with Salem's team. They've got some quickness on the floor. Should allow them to take those open shots, just like that one by Kenneth Cornell.
Exactly right there. You'll have to be real tall in this game. Just get wide open shots and make them, like Kenny McCornell did right there.
Smart shots lead to baskets, and basket leads to points, and that hopefully leads to a victory, unless you don't get back on defense.
Wide open three by Austin, but the lefty in the corner.
Lefty. Don't see that too often.
Reminds me of Taylor Palermo, baseball player for the Salem Tigers.
Great lefty, good athlete, insane work ethic.
Oh, he's outrageous. He's probably at the gym as we speak.
Would not surprise me one bit. Jamal Robinson drives into lane, kick out to Kamar LeBrew. Floater is good.
Good drive in there by Jamal Robinson. K.K. LeBrew just standing right outside with a nice easy lane.
Salem sitting in a full court defense. Brown, pull up, jumper, back rim, no good, rebound, Kamar LeBrew.
Good hustle there by LeBrew, getting that defensive rebound.
Turnover on Salem, and it seems that Kamar LeBrew has come up a little sore.
A couple times tonight, he's come up a little limp on that bum lower body injury.
In the game for Salem, number 11, Corey Prophet. Cedarville goes back inside to Wabo, pump fake inside the lane, and rebound. Once again, goes back up and is good.
Wabo, a big, strong guy, really causing problems here for the Tigers, especially now the Tigers have gone to a shorter lineup. Wabo was 6'7", so really causing problems down low here.
Tallest man on the court currently for Salem is standing 6'4". It's a 3-inch difference. Who knows what the wingspan is for Nawabo, but it seems to be a big one that Salem can't overcome at the moment.
Hopefully the Tigers can use their speed and start making the shots on the other end to get back in this game before the half.
With 45 seconds to go, Salem trails 45-36. That full court pressure defense by Cedarville is causing so much trouble for Salem. Out of bounds on Cedarville, goes off number 24, Brown's foot.
Coach Unger wanting a timeout. The referee is not paying attention, but he got it.
Salem currently trailing by 9 with 38 seconds, 37 seconds to go in the half. Salem has to come out, has to score a good basket, waste the clock as much as they can. They got a new shot clock off the out of bounds off Cedarville. Use all 35 seconds, take one smart shot, go in the half with points. Come back out, get momentum, and turn this game right around.
That's exactly what they need to do. They need to find some momentum for this second half. Get these fans into it. Once they get into it, this team really seems to rise to the next level. And if they can do that, this game could turn around for them in the second half.
Just got to hope they don't come out like they did against Urbana, sleeping, not even on the court, looked like zombies playing. Corey Prophet, number 11, to inbound the ball for Salem International. Deep pass to Jamal Robinson. Raymar Porter taking control of this offense with Kamar LeBrew on the bench. Exactly like we discussed, killing clock, looking for that last basket of the half, go in with some points, leading with some energy. Hopefully they can convert. 10 seconds to go on the shot clock. Trying to find that man with 5 seconds to go. Porter for three. Rebound goes to Cedarville. Desperation three. No good. At the half, Salem National is trailing Cedarville 45-36. We will be back with your halftime points.
Please clear the court. signing day. They're really big. Active offseason. This is for the hat and coach there.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're back for the start of the second half. Salem has shot decently well, but the problem is they have been fouling like it is a sickness. It's uncontrollable.
They got to be more disciplined if they're going to win this ball game. They've really been sloppy early on in the first half, and like our technical producer David Olivero said, Cedarville, they don't make mistakes, and they play great basketball. If you're going to give them opportunities, they're going to take them, and that's what they've done tonight. That's why they have the 9-point lead they have at the half.
Well, Cedarville has the ball in the second half and bringing the ball in up the court for Cedarville. Number 24, Zach Brown.
Somebody's got to take over for this Salem team in the second half. Take over and bring some momentum to this team.
Drive, baseline floater is good by Cedarville. Number 21, Austin Foote. Porter from way downtown. No good rebound, Freddie Dwarf. Salem slowly trying to set their offense up, playing with the small lineup that they finished with in the first half. Just have to get something going early on. No good, McCornell rebound to Sewell. Sewell layup, good.
Nice offensive board there by Sewell. Good job there. Good hustle there by the Tigers.
Bring the ball to the court for Cedarville, number 24, Brown. Foul on the floor, number 32, Jeremy Sewell. Team's first, his third. Falling down, number 32, Nwaba, who's just toying with the Salem defense. Rebound goes to Raymar Porter.
Here come the Tigers.
Roper pump fake at the elbow, drive into the baseline, passes underneath the Sewell. Pump fake rejected by Nwaba.
Nice shot there by Sewell to stay with it. Now McConnell's turn for the layup, and he got it.
Good job there by Salem by not giving up on the offensive side of the ball. Being rejected, going right back at the rim, putting that basket in for two.
Absolutely. Now they got to play defense, and they do with a steal there by Raymar Porter.
Freddie Adwar up to McCornell. McCornell for three is good.
Kenneth McCornell, nice big three there. Hopefully that can bring some momentum to this Tigers ball club.
Timeout on the floor for Salem. It's a good start for Salem in the second half coming out. Four quick points, bringing them back within 4 points on Cedarville. McCornell for three, also not giving up on the offensive end and causing a turnover on the defense, something that has to continue this whole second half.
Very good hustle on the offensive end, not getting discouraged on the missed shots and staying with the ball there. We saw it twice early on here, and let's hope it continues. They're right back in this game, only down 4 points right now.
Inbounding the ball for Cedarville. Number 32, Jimmy Nwaba. Bringing the ball up the court. Number 21, Austin Foote.
Nice man-to-man defense here by the Tigers.
Ooh, good tough defense there by number 4, Kenneth Cornell.
You gotta keep your hands. You can't hold the offensive player while he's got the ball. You just can't do that there. Kenny McCornell's gotta be a little bit smarter than that.
I don't believe in any sport, football, basketball, soccer, hockey, you can hold somebody. It's a penalty no matter what.
Exactly.
Cedarville looking for that man inside. Can't find him. And a steal by number 5, Raymond Porter. In the lane, layup is good.
Good hustle there, Raymond Porter with the steal. Coast to coast with the layup. Here comes Salem with that intensity. I got to keep it going here if they want to win this game.
Cedarville trying to slow down this game. Play their style of offense is slow, meticulous offense. Find the right guy, making the right shots, and converting. Good tough battle inside between number 32. Guabo and number 1, Freddie Edouard.
Really going at it, and a block there by Kenny McCornell.
Into the game for sale, number 3, Jamal Robinson. Into the game for sale, number 14, Daniel Hickman. Yeah, I did notice at the end of that halftime that Kamar LeBrew did come back onto the court with ice on his knee. It looks skeptical for him to come back in this second half. Just a strong play down low by number 32, Nwaba.
He's bigger, he's stronger, and right now he's getting the best of the Salem defense.
Salem trails by 4, 17 minutes to go. Rebound to Cedarville.
Zimmy's got 15 points here in this game, leading the Cedarville Yellow Jackets.
Floater in the lane is good. Leading scorer for Salem currently is Raymar Porter with 12. Just keeping the offense in this game, keeping Salem in the game right now. He's got to heat up from behind the arc like he did in the first half and really bring them back into this game.
Sloppy possession there. Good hustle by Raymar Porter to get that basketball. And it's turned right back over.
Raymar looks a little dazed after that. Got landed on by a big man. Rebound, no good. Rebound, Kenneth Cornell. And pass by Raymar.
Full court pass there. Not a smart move by Raymar Porter. Another turnover. Tigers real sloppy possessions here. Really got to control themselves and control that basketball.
On the defensive end of the ball. Charging call on number 24, Zach Brown. Raymar Porter putting his body, his face, his head on the line.
Unfortunately, there was a foul right before he got hit. The referees are discussing it. They're going to give it to Salem.
Entering the game for Salem, number 25, Dexter Batts Jr., and number 21, Walter Brock.
They've really got to get smarter with the basketball here. Have a good possession. Cedarville's real big and tough right now. And Salem's really got to control themselves, get good shots, and really play smart to finish this game out.
Robinson kick out to Batts. Back up top to Porter, who is trying to find the open man, trying to set this offense up. Big difference in offenses we see today. We got a really well-structured offense from Cedarville and somewhat of a slight scramble from Salem today.
Absolutely. They just haven't been able to get in a rhythm.
Shot from behind the arc is good. Jason Cuffey for 3. Cornell with a step-back jumper. Front rim, rebound goes to Cuffey and stolen away by Porter, who pulls up, bank shot, no good, rebound, Cuffey. Look at a push-off foul, number 34, his 13 seconds. Apparently, partner hands is up in the air, did not see that foul, couldn't agree with him more, I didn't see anything there. But enter the game for Salem, number 24, Alex Webb, number 11, Corey Proffitt.
Alex Webb getting his first action here tonight.
Inbound pass to Kenneth Cornell. He'll hand the ball off to Corey Provitt, who will start to run the offense. Trying to find that open man. Really good defense today by Cedarville, not allowing Salem to find the open guy.
Nice job by Provitt to take it in. He's just got to take it up strong. Maybe draw a foul there, you know, kind of hesitate a little bit and didn't work out for him. Luckily, Cedarville knocked it out of bounds.
Batch drives into the lane. Hand off to McCornell. Floater is good.
Nice look there by Dexter Batch. Getting McCornell in the right spot at the right time for the easy layup.
Salem currently trails with 14 and a half go in the second half, 54 to 47. Brown drives into the lane, kicks out to Cuffey. Cuffey from behind the arc. No good. Rebound goes to Robinson, who kept his foot inside the line.
Nice job there by Robinson.
An unnecessary look for an alley-oop there. Cedarville inbound the ball on the errant pass by Jamal Robinson. Salem in a full court press, 14 minutes to go.
Really have to get that intensity back up and get back in this game.
Try and draw the crowd into the game, get some energy and feel it on the floor.
They play well when that crowd gets behind them. They seem to rise up a little bit more.
Another foul on Salem, unnecessary. On number 24, Alex Webb, his first, team's third.
It has been better in the second half. It's only their third. Overall, though, they've really got to pick that up.
Couldn't agree more. Cedarville still able to run their offense really smooth. LU pass through to Wabo, showing Salem how it's supposed to be done.
That's exactly how it's supposed to be done. Nice job there by Cedarville.
Salem can't seem to find that man inside. Currently continuously looking for that outside shot. And they need to take the ball to the hole.
Got to contain the dribble. Kenny McConnell's got to get back up, not just lay on the court.
Webb from the corner is no good. Rebound to Brown. Cedarville from behind the arc is good. Number 22, Marcus Rankey, wide open for a three.
Wide open. Holy cow, he had all day to shoot that one.
Freddie Edouard, pump fake, dribble into the lane. Photo off backboard, no good. And we got a jump ball.
Jump ball, it's going to stay here. The hustle man, Freddie Edouard, with that one. Keeps the ball down here. Really have to clean up their possessions, you know, for the rest of this game.
Freddie with the head fake, pump fake. Trying to get his man loose. McCornell with the floater and is fouled. Fouls on number 24, Zach Brown, his second, team's third. To the line and shoot two. Number four, Kenneth Cornell. Shot is up and good. End of the game for Salem. Number three, Jamal Robinson. Number five, Raymar Porter. Number 32, Jeremy Sewell. Also in the game, number one, Brian Hecker, and number 21, Austin Foote. Salem trails with 12:40 to go by 10, 59-49.
Not out of it yet. They can play some good, strong defense here and get some more buckets. They get right back in this game.
Inside to Nawabo, a continuous play that works for Cedarville. Salem's got to find an answer for the big man. Sewell back down, kick out past the Bats, who back rim rebound goes to Cedarville.
Out tough there is Jamal Robinson. Almost another alley-oop there by Cedarville, but here come the Tigers.
Good job by Raymar Porter, finding the man behind him, and bats inside of Robinson for two.
Cedarville didn't get back on that defensive transition there. Led to the wide open layup for Jamal Robinson.
Somebody in for sale, number 33, Jameel Pettyway. Salem wasn't in a full court press, but has dropped back into a 2-3 zone. Shot for three, good from Cedarville. Cedarville is slowly starting to heat up from behind the arc.
Slowly starting to heat up is right, and they're getting in a groove here and extending that lead.
Attempt no look pass by Robinson is thrown away, and that possession is as well.
Eye contact is key in passing. I learned that in the Mexican League.
That is correct. You are a three-time Mexican League champion, and
especially when you don't speak the same language, eye contact is key.
Very important in most sports, I believe. Cedarville looking inside for that big guy continuously, and another basket by number one, Brian Hecker. Another inside point from in the key.
Really sloppy offensive possessions here for the Tigers. Really not getting anything going. It looks like five individuals out there rather than a team offense right now. And it's really hurt them here in this game.
Dribble drive baseline by Raymar Porter. Layup is good. Salem's got to find a way to come together as a unit on the offensive side of the ball instead of fighting each other for passes and shots. They're not going to be able to win this game if they can't find that rhythm. Another inside pass.
Good look there by Brian Hecker finding a wide open number 13, Brian Grant, for yet another easy layup. Cedarville starting to take this lead into the second half. 23-17 run here in the second half.
At the end of the game, I want to see the stat for points in the paint. Compare them from Cedarville to Salem.
Bit of a flop there by Cedarville, number 23, Zach Brown.
Oh, fouls on number 32, Jeremy Sewell. And I believe flopping now in hockey is a penalty, so they bring that into this sport. And who knows, might be a blocking call, maybe even a technical foul next time that happens.
Yeah, not a... Not a very good observation there by the referee, but they gave it right to him.
Rebound by Cuffey. Putback is good. Salem's trailing by 17 with 10 minutes to go, 70 to 30.
Slowly slipping away. Just moments ago was a 10-point lead with an opportunity to get back into the game.
Good job there by Pettiway. Drive baseline, pump fake, go up for the layup. Easy 2 points right there. Cuffey passes it back out to Grant, and the shot is good. Raymar Porter trying to carry this offense, and it's been very, very difficult not being playing as one unit, but as a collective of colleagues. Roper to Edouard, who pulls up from behind the arc and is good for three. Salem still continues to trail by a large margin after that three ball. Active hands, turnover steal for Salem. Freddie Edouard backs down in the lane, handoff to Pettiway. Pettiway floater, no good. Rebound to Cedarville.
Pettiway's got to realize not to throw it off the backboard right there. Just lay it up.
Freddie Edwards foul, his fourth, team's fifth.
First hit.
With 8:52 to go, Salem's trailing Cedarville 72-58. In the game for Salem after that timeout, number 4, Kenneth McCornell. Salem in a full court press, easily fooled by Cedarville. Brown into the lane, kick out pass to Hecker. Hecker from behind the arc, no good. Rebound, Freddie Edouard.
Another wide open look there. They finally miss one. Here comes the Tigers offense.
Hopefully they can set something up, come back in the game with a good basket right here. Fouls on number 1, Brian Hecker. His third, team's fourth. Cornell in the middle of the ball. And that was tipped.
Copy so pass there by Cedarville, or by Salem, and Cedarville is ready to pounce on it. I'm good.
Bats from behind the arc. No good. Rebound, Freddie Edouard. Goes up and is fouled. Good job there by number 1, Freddie Edouard. To stay with it, go back up, get fouled, and go to the line and shoot 2 free throws. Fouls on number 14. Or 13, my apologies. Brian Grant, his 13th, fifth. End of the game for Cedarville, number 32, Zibby Nwaba. Number 21, Austin Foote. End of the game for Salem, number 3, Jamal Robinson.
This game's still not out of reach. The Tigers, if they can get on a little run here, get a little momentum swinging in their direction, they can get right back in this game.
And second basket is good. Salem is trailing by 12 with 8 minutes to go in the second half. Salem's playing a very aggressive defense right now, active hands. And the leader of that defense is, again, number one, Freddie Aguilar. Active hands right there, causing another turnover. Salem's ball going back down the court.
Hopefully this continues, a little momentum swing. Here come that Tigers team. This place starting to get a little bit louder. Hopefully this team can feed off of that and start to rise up.
In the game for Salem, number five, Raymar Porter. Salem trying to find that man with the shot, and ball handle loss. And a foul on number one, Freddie Aguilar. Foul. That's his fifth, team sixth. Five fouls for Freddie, he's done for the game. That's an unfortunate loss for Salem on the defensive side of the ball. Causing a lot of turnovers, a lot of anger it seems coming from the offensive Cervo when he's out there, active hands constantly.
You got to look back in the first half, though, with the little sloppy fouls. This is where it costs you late in the game when you're trying to get back into it. Those fouls early on in the game cost you now.
Florida's no good. Rebound, Kenneth Cornell. And a turnover by Kenneth Cornell on the offensive side for Salem. Seville continues to go to look inside for number 32, Nwabo. Can't find him. Shot, no good. Rebound, number five, Raymar Porter, who thought about throwing that long bomb, but thought well and didn't take it.
He's thrown a couple interceptions today. Looks like he had a second thought there.
Shot by Ropers, no good. Rebound, Nwabo. Both teams shooting the exact same from behind the arc. 6 for 18 for 33%. And a good job on the defense side of the ball by Salem, causing Brian Grant to walk with the ball, which is once again illegal in this sport.
And people still try to get away with it.
Supposedly in the NBA, they allow you to take 5 steps. I have no idea why.
Well, if you're LeBron James, you can do whatever you want to.
Inside to Bats. Bats pump fakes. Layup. No good. Rebound. Corey Proffitt. Last touch by Cedarville. Salem
good
ball.
Good hustle there by Corey Proffitt. Keep Tigers in possession here.
Everything in for Salem. Number 24, Alex Webb. Also entering the game for Salem. Number 32, Jeremy Sewell. Salem still trails by 12 with 6:20 to go in the second half. Still have plenty of time to come back and win this game. Shot by Porter. No good. Rebound. Wabo.
That guy just completely taking this game into his own hands. 19 points, 6 rebounds. Good night for that young man.
Leading scorer for Cedarville, averaging 18.1 points a game and 17.2 rebounds. You can see it why tonight. Big man, strong inside right there. Effortless job.
There he is again, just bigger and stronger than the Salem defense. Anybody they've put on him tonight, he's just gone right through him. Alex Webb throwing it right off the defender's knee. Back to Jamal Robinson.
Raymar Porter trying to set this offense up, trying to find a shot for him, maybe one of his teammates. Inside pass to Sewell. Sewell floater, good! Brown bring the ball, pass half for Cedarville. Foot trying to set the offense up, looking inside, dribble into the lane, and it's fouled. That was on number 24, Alex Webb, his second, team seventh, and that was a sloppy foul from Marvio up here.
Yes, it was another foul for the Salem Tigers. getting the Cedarville Yellow Jackets right back to the line.
First shot is good by number 21, Austin Foote. Entering the game for Cedarville, number 22, Marcus Renke. As well, number 14, Daniel Hickman. Second shot is up and is no good. Rebound, Alex Webb. Salem can't find that inside man. They have to find that shot from the outside, find an open man, and take those high percentage jump shots. Jamal Robinson calling it. I'll play with 15 seconds left on the shot clock. Porter slips, loses his tire. Trying to drive the lane there. Corey Proffitt resetting up top with 5 seconds to go. Pull-up jumper is no good. Shot clock violation. That's the second time tonight Salem has violated that 35-second shot clock.
Just not getting anything going. A lot of frustrated faces in this Tigers huddle right now. A lot of down attitudes right now. They just have got to find a way out. You know, this happened the other night against Urbana. They're just in a funk right now. And, you know, like we hoped last game, they can build off in the next 4.5 minutes to go into the next game.
Inbounding the ball for Cedarville, number one, Brian Hecker. Salem pressuring with 4.5 to go. Trying to cause turnover to quick basket, bring himself back within 10. Great job defensively by Corey Proffitt.
Good hustle there by Proffitt. Way to stay in front of his man.
Shot by Renke, no good, rebound. And there's a foul on number, it's going to be a 32 because both guys are wearing 32.
Great observation there, Mr. Schwartz.
Jeremy Sewell on Salem, his fifth foul of the game, team's eighth.
Come up with a foul and a bruise, double punishment there.
Well, make it triple because he just fouled himself out of the game.
Oh, what a tough game this is. Number 23, Roper coming back in.
Wobble to the line, shoot the 1-1. First shot is up and good. Second shot up, front rim, rebound, Kenneth Cornell. Long pass to Alex Webb, pump fake, and is good.
Good offensive transition there from Proffitt to Alex Webb. And good defense there by the Tigers. Still an opportunity to get back in this game. They just have to get hot and keep it going here.
Seven, Oh, back to the game. Had some little action in the crowd there. Fan being escorted out of the stadium. Or gymnasium. Drive into the lane by Porter and his foul on the floor.
Oh, they're not going to give it to him. Nice hustle there. Good job there by Raymar Porter driving in hard. Draw the foul.
Foul's on number 34. Jason Cuffey, his fourth, team sixth. And the game,
really don't
14.
Like to see the fan, the home fans acting like that. Just no need for that in this game.
It's not necessary being down by 12. Inside pass to Kevin Cornell, layup is good.
Here they come. They got to play defense here to try to get back in this game. It's a 10-point game. Still plenty of time if they can continue to get hot.
3:20 to go. Plenty of time to come back with this game. Inside pass to Nwabo. And loses the ball handle. Also goes back up. No good rebound. Back to Cedarville.
Great defense there by the Tigers. Denying them three times right there. Hopefully. And they're going to call a foul on Nwabo.
Big Bang getting frustrated down low with the tough defense by Salem. Decides to throw an elbow, knock down Jonathan Roper. That's the first foul on the big man from Cedarville in the Wild Battle. That's the team's seventh.
That was great hustle. Good defensive possession right there by the Salem Tigers. Here they come. Hopefully they can continue this hot streak.
Pump fake from Alex Webb. Dribble into the lane. Kick out to Profit. Corey Profit trying to slow the offense down, trying to find a way to set up for that good open shot. Floater in the lane by Corey is no good. Rebound the big man, Nwabo.
Good drive there by Profit. Tried to draw a little contact, but he didn't right there.
Salem playing some really good defense inside so far. Wide open three. No good. Rebound to Kenneth Cornell.
Got
to
score some points here if you're the Tigers. Keep the comeback alive.
A big three right now would put them back within nine, something they need. Good save by Alex Webb. Scramble for the ball and another foul. Foul's on Nwabo, his second. Team's eighth. That's 1-1. That's the bonus. Kenneth Cornell go to the line.
Salem's got, you know, a great opportunity to get back in this game. You know, they're in the bonus for the fouls. You know, they're playing good defense right now. A big opportunity for the Tigers here.
First shot is good. Second rewarded. Salem with the nine.
Good to see this Tigers team showing some fight, something they didn't show against Urbana in their last outing. You know, it's really good to see, and hopefully they can continue with the final 2 minutes.
Second shot is front rim and good. Salem within eight with 2:07 to go, trailing 76-68. And we enter the game for Cedarville, number 34, Jason Cuffey. Salem running a full court press. Great defense there by number 5, Raymar Porter. Timeout called by Cedarville, 30-second timeout.
Good defense there by the Tigers, led to Cedarville having to call a timeout.
Inbound ball for Cedarville, number 1, Brian Hecker. Good defense by Salem, but just giving lane. Tip back, no good. Tip back, no good. Rebound, Nwabo. Scramble for the ball on the ground.
Outworking Nwabo that time. They got to continue to outwork him if they want to get back in this game.
Jump ball goes to Cedarville. Cedarville inbound the ball underneath the basket. Looking inside for Nwabo. Looking to isolate Nwabo on Roper. Foul, Robinson.
An aggressive foul there by Jamal Robinson.
Foul is on number three, Jamal Robinson, his second, team's ninth.
Nwabo 6 of 8 from the line tonight. Double-double for Zimmy Nwabo. 22 points and 10 rebounds.
The line of shoot first is good. Second is good. The lead is back to 10 with a minute 45 to go. Robinson kick out to Webb from behind the arc. It's good for three.
Big three there by Alex Webb. Just keep the drive alive here. If this continues, get back in this ball game.
Ryan Hecker once again to inbound the ball. Salem in a full court press.
Out of pressure. We got to keep a body on him.
Salem's got to come up with the ball for the next few seconds here to keep their option alive and coming back in this game. Drive by Brown. Is good. Salem trailing by 9 with 1 minute to go.
Can't take a lot of time off the clock here. Gotta get down and get a good shot early. 9-point game with 50 seconds left.
Drive inside by Raymar Porter. Skip to my Lou is good.
Skip to my Lou, a little razzle dazzle there for Raymar Porter. 7-point game. The only question I have, is there enough time?
That is a very good question. With 41 seconds to go, Salem is trailing 80-73. It's a tough call. They got to get a big stop on the defense, come back, shoot a quick three ball, puts them back within 4. It's a very, very tough situation, but nothing's ever impossible in sports nowadays.
This just goes back to the fouls early on in the first half that have really crippled this team for the entire game. 22 of 27 from the free throw line, and that's really changed this game, you know, from the very first half on. Good full court press here by the Tigers.
Can't foul. And we have a foul. 24, Alex Webb. An unnecessary foul there. His third, team's 10th.
They are in the bonus. If they do miss a couple free throws, maybe they get down, get a nice three. And he missed it. It's a big step here. You know, if Salem's going to get back in this game, there's not a lot of time and a lot of points to score.
Missed both. Rebound, Nuovo. Foul once again. Salem has to find a way to stop that big guy. What's that? 11 rebounds, 24 points, going to the line to shoot his 11th and 12th free throws of the game. Just cannot allow someone to get in the line that often in one game.
It's been the difference in this game so far.
First is good. Second shot is good. Quick pass in, Kenny McCornell. Porter from behind the arc gives no good. Air ball. Webb for three. Foul is on number 32, Jimmy Nuovo. His third, team's ninth. The foul was not on the shooter. It was on Jamal Robinson, who got pushed in front of Alex Webb after he finished his shot.
Jamal Robinson, one of two from the free throw line. He's got 7 points in the game tonight.
Shot is good. Thank you, bonus. Second shot is in, good. Steep mountain to climb still, 22 seconds left. Salem trails, 85-75. Good action.
And we got a steal. 13 seconds on the clock.
Profit for three. Rims out, rebound, Robinson. Goes back up and is fouled.
2.5 seconds on the clock. They took way too much time off the clock there. Doesn't look like it's going to be enough for the Tigers here tonight, but an impressive finish. I mean, let's give them credit. They played hard the last, you know, 8 or so minutes. It really turned the game around. It looked like there was going to be a little bit of a blowout there for Cedarville, but, you know, give the Tigers credit. They came back. They started making shots and playing very nice defense. Just not enough for them here.
At one point, Cedarville did lead by 17. Salem has brought it back within 6 points, something encouraging to see, something they didn't show against Urbana, where they just, you know, basically said, we're losing, why keep trying?
They've outscored Cedarville 41-37 in the second half.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the final score is 82 for Cedarville, and for Salem National Tigers, 77. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to end this game off right here as we are going to talk about the inside play by number 32, Jimmy Nuovo, coming out with a double-double, 11 rebounds, 26 points, something impressive you like to see from a big man, something Salem did not have an answer for. Also, Salem has to learn to use their hands properly. They've been very active on the defense, but also bringing in the unnecessary fouls, which allowed Cedarville to go to the line 31 times in a game. That is unheard of and unnecessary. Last few points I want to make is Cedarville's offense was well structured and almost flawless in that first half. They showed how to run an offense and how to maintain ball movement, body movement to open up the shots every time. Now, the next game for Salem is at Damon College, January 26th at 4 p.m. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you once again for listening in on this bone-chilling night here on Salem International. where the Cedarville Yellow Jackets swarm the St. Louis National Tigers. Ladies and gentlemen, have a good night, stay warm, and we'll see you next time.